Good morning, GVA. Happy Friday. I hope you guys are having a great day so far. So today our assembly consists of a couple different things. We have flag and character focus, and then a couple GVA students are going to say hi, and then we have Quest for Kindness with Miss Kona, and then we have a couple different surprises for you guys today. We have Miss Valerie, who is going to be giving a mystery person interview today, and then we have a couple more lip syncs for you guys.
Hand over your heart, ready, salute. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
GVAK, over your heart, ready, begin. As a GVA student, I promise to be kind in all I say and do, to be safe at all times, to do my best at home, at school, and everywhere I go. Because it's the right thing to do.
GVA and happy Friday. I have the absolute pleasure of recognizing students who went above and beyond in our character focus this week. And this week we're focusing on the connecting habit of accepting others and, as a bonus, accepting our circumstances and making the best of it. And I am excited to recognize these students who really made a difference in their household and in their community by showing acceptance of others. And let's give it up for Nailani Luna, Jordan Garnica, Zachariah Plata, Sydney Solicter, Alexander Kona, Scarlett Logan and Colby Johnson, Azalea Foster, Ebenezer Wardofa, Samuel and Jacob Rosas Monares, Julian Ballesteros, Alan and Jacqueline Padilla, Sophia Serrato, Mason Crutchfield, Roberto Morales, Logan and Liam Ortega, Giovanni Madrigal, Jasmine Sebastian, Andrew Ribeiro, Maya Stein, Ellie and Mitzi Cook, Carlos Luna, Belen and Ebenezer Wardofa, Sophia Imiwu, Adrian and Aaliyah Perez, Eli Brisa and Sergio Jaquez, Imani Holmes Marrero, Caitlin Duncan, Asa and Elijah Roseblade, Ashley and Jeffrey Garcia, Perry Rodriguez, Elowen and Shayla Lopez, Diego and Santino Magana, Kinley Busick, Rhett Haley, Sienna Bustamante, Miley Velasquez, Wesley Slauson, Alec Lopez, Emmeline and Jeremiah Werner, Caden Cardisano, Eddie Vega and Avery Vega, Peyton Hillen, Michael Madrid, Emma, Olivia, and Sierra Dormer. Excellent job, students, in going above and beyond in sharing our character focus and our connecting habit of acceptance. Really important as we navigate this crisis and as we spend even more time with our loved ones to be able to accept those people around us and to accept and make the best of our situation. So super proud of you for making a difference. Super proud of you for continuing to be leaders, even in this unusual situation. And I am excited to celebrate all of you. And I'm excited to talk about our next character focus a little bit later. All right, excellent job. Have a great day.
Hi, it's Kate from Leadership.
Hi, GVA.
Hi, everyone. This is Mallory from Leadership. I just want to say hi.
Hi.
Hey, Miss Valerie.
Tell me something.
Not boring.
Don't nobody want to hear about that.
PA, it's Miss Valerie, and I've got a new segment for you guys, and it is called Not Boring. Okay, that's what it is. Okay, that means I'm going to be interviewing people about stuff that you actually care about and not boring stuff like what's your favorite color, because don't nobody want to hear that. Okay, so the very first guest on Miss Valerie's show this time is the one, the only, Mr. Howe. Woo! GBA principal! What up, Mr. Howe? So glad to have you. Now, what you don't know, Mr. Howe, is I actually have a co-host. Okay?
Oh.
It is Diva Chick. Okay? There she is. Right?
Diva
Chick. Fabulous. She's fabulous. And she is going to help me out today. She keeps us on track. I just want to warn you, she gets bored very fast. You don't want to be hearing a blah, 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 blah. Okay? So I listen to her. She also has all the questions for me. She's going to whisper them in my ear, and we're going to ask. Okay? You got that?
Yeah, absolutely. Right. It's Diva Chick's show.
All right, Diva Chick. Okay, so she's got some questions, and I need you to answer them honestly for the kids, and they're interesting. She's been asking some kids, okay? She's going to give me the first question.
Perfect.
Girl, what is it? Okay. All right, this one's good. If you were to have a superpower,
another one? Another superpower?
I ain't got no superpowers, okay? Anyway, unless it was like talking, and I got that one, so, and I think I probably got you beat. Yeah. Okay, so, superpower.
Okay.
Diva Chick says stay focused. Okay, so, all right, so. Out of these four, which one would you pick? Time travel, super speed, flying, or shape-shifting? Go.
Okay. First, I have to know, are you going to ask other people the same question?
This is not your show. Okay? Diva Chick said ain't none of your business. So we going to need to know what your answer. Told you she's snappy. Okay, what is it?
Diva
Just
Chick.
Pick what I gave you for.
Okay, well, I was curious because there is only one answer. I didn't want to ruin it for people who followed me. But if I'm not going to worry about that,
you know. Ain't nobody following you.
I got to satisfy Diva Chick. So there is only one right answer, and I'll tell you why. Because, first of all, if anybody has watched The Flash, you know that messing with the time-space continuum is nothing but headache. And so time travel is out.
Okay.
I would love super speed and flight. But here's the thing. If I can shapeshift, I can become an animal that is either fast or can fly, so therefore, I choose shape-shifting, only right answer.
Diva Chick said that makes total sense, so we're cool with that. That was good. That was good.
Okay, that's an icebreaker. Good.
Yeah, she actually agrees. Okay, so we're going to give you that one.
Perfect.
And you get that one. All right, good. All right, here is another one. It better have nothing to do with chicken. She wants to know, she just said that, what is the grossest thing you've ever ate?
Okay. This requires a brief story. So I used
to... Diva Chick don't like long Chick. Stories. You need to get in. We ain't got all day to work at it. Okay, fine.
This is important.
Make it quick.
So I used to teach. And so as a teacher, I would bring my lunch and I would keep it in my fridge in my classroom. And one day I took out the leftovers that I had brought from home, and it was rice and some meat and some gravy. It looked fantastic. And so I took it out. I warmed it up in the microwave, so it was really hot and toasty and aromatic. And then I took a bite, and a few chews in, I realized that these leftovers tasted absolutely terrible. And it took me a few minutes to realize that those leftovers were not for me. They were actually, it was rice and dog food that I had microwaved and was eating, thinking that I had scored some leftovers for myself. No, it was the dog food that I was eating, and it was absolutely disgusting.
But so was it good?
There is
was it
once
good?
Again, there is one clear right answer, and it is the rice and dog food.
But was it good? Was it tasty?
No, it was terrible. It was terrible. Look. Obviously, it was the wet dog food, right? So it was...
I think your dog set that up and was like, this food is nasty and I'm going to set it up so you can taste it and don't feed me this mess anymore.
Well, that's true.
Even the dog didn't want that mess.
Not man's best friend, I will tell you.
He's like, don't nobody want that dog food. Mm-hmm. All right, that was good. That was good. I get that tea. Diva Chick is liking your answers, and she's testy. All right. All right. We got another one here. We got another one. Okay, this one could be lame depending upon your answer for us, but you sure? All right, she said coachy. She really wants to know because she don't think the answer is principal. So, what did you want to be when you were a kid?
Oh, it's important that you qualify because there have been a lot of things I have been interested in. But I happen to know, it is documented, that the earliest answer to this question for Russ Howell was snake. When I grew up, I wanted to be a snake. Survey says?
First of all, Diva Chick don't like snakes, okay? And they eat chicks. And so we're giving you a big X on that answer because we don't like, you can't be a snake. Well, I'm glad you're not a snake, Mr. Howell, because Miss Valerie would have nothing to do with you. That would be the end of our relationship.
I've heard that snakes eat the critical and judgmental chicks first. I just want to put that out there.
I know. She is, okay, just for that, we got one last bonus question, and this is it. Only because she's annoyed now with you. So she may just peck at you. One more question. Have you ever broken a bone?
I have. I have broken one bone, and it is actually this bone right here. If you were to look.
Nobody wants to get ill. Get out. First of all, you need to blow your nose. Nobody wants to see the demon.
If you were to look really closely, my nose is actually a little bit crooked right in here.
Okay, how did you break it?
Well, playing basketball. It was a very manly injury.
Were you trying to dunk? Or did you just trip over the water container?
So I had just dunked. I had just elevated.
Oh, yeah.
Over somebody. And then my feet got tangled up in the three people beneath me, and I landed on my face and broke my nose.
You landed on your face.
Yeah. That's actually not true at all. Only the basketball. I did break my nose.
I was totally believing you.
But it had nothing to do with dunking the basketball. I can assure you of that.
All right. That was good. The bone didn't come out, did it?
No, it did not come out, but they
had. Was there a lot of blood?
There was a lot of blood. In fact, you know, bonus. I once had a bloody nose that was so bad, blood was coming out of the tear ducts in my.
Oh!
I was crying blood. That's just bonus. But yes, a lot of blood, and it was crooked, and they had to shove things up into my nose as part of the procedure to fix it. And when they pulled them out, it literally felt like they were pulling pieces of my brain out through my nose.
That was a good bonus. That's something that the kids appreciate knowing about Mr. Howell, because that is something that is definitely not boring. Well, I have to say, me and Diva Chick had a great time with this first segment of
Tell Me Something
Not Boring. Okay, it was a great time. I am so glad we got to interview you, and stay tuned for the next episode of Miss Valerie's Not Born. Don't know what to hear.
Very nice. I just want to say thank you, and thank you, Diva Chick. It was an honor and a privilege, and I will make sure all of my snake friends give you plenty of space and leave you alone. So thank you very much for having me. I appreciate it. Bye, everybody.
Bye.
Next up is Miss Kona with Quest for Kindness. Let's see what she has to say.
Hey, DVA. This is Kona again with Quest for Kindness. And yes, as promised, I have a new cape. It is my Batman cape. Channeling the Batman today. So, since we last spoke, I had a couple of people tell me some great things that are going on out there. I know there are more than people are telling me. And remember, if you want to tell me what's going on out there, the kindness that you are spreading, you can go ahead and email me. It's a.kona@greatvalleyacademy.com. If you want to tell me some things that you are doing at your house to spread kindness at this time when we can't all be together, you let me know. Today's quest for kindness, I have a couple of them. The first one is I would like to acknowledge the members of Mr. King's class. There is a student in there who brings her sister along for the Flipgrids, and I saw one of them, and it was super adorable. And it's nice at this point when you're not, when you're maybe at home with your siblings, and then you're not like separated out into different classrooms like you would be at school, and you are all together. And it's nice to be able to kind of use each other and like show, you know, show different members of your family and give them jobs and be kind to them. And I appreciate this student in Mr. King's class. Let's go ahead and give them a howl and a clap. Oh! And as always, if you could go ahead and howl and clap at home, I would be doing it by myself. Next one, I would like to acknowledge the leadership class. The leadership class is putting on this very video, this one you're seeing, this virtual assembly. The leadership class is doing that. And this is hard. This is so hard. Trust me. This is so hard. These recording videos, the putting together of all the things. Mrs. Carter's doing a great job, and she acknowledged that her leadership students are also doing a great job getting outside of their comfort zone, doing these things to help foster the sense of community for GVA. And so I would like to give a howl and a clap to the leadership class. Oh! And finally, there's a student in Mr. Sluggett's class who painted, and I haven't seen this yet, but painted a special item for another student in Mr. Sluggett's class, is doing that out of the kindness of their heart, would like to share their art and their feelings with this other student. And it's nice to acknowledge others, and it's hard to do it like this, but it's nice to acknowledge others and share your art and share your talents. And so I would like to thank that member of Mr. Sluggett's class. Hello! So good job, GVA. This is another one of these weeks is down, right? This is our Friday, and we're not all together in that way that we usually are out there on the blacktop, you know, looking at the stage, seeing what's going on. This is our assemblies now, and I think they're great. I wish I could see everybody, though. So keep being kind in your heart, and keep being kind in your actions, and keep that GVA pledge at home too, you know, because you've got to do it at home, at school, and everywhere you go, which I know isn't a whole lot of places right now. But keep up that kindness for me, GVA. I am going to attach another video to this video of me singing a song that is near and dear to my heart. It's an oldie but goodie from my friend Cookie Monster. So I'll see you in a minute.
Hey, GVA, I told you I would attach a video. I have now put on my Cookie Monster sweater, which my third grade friends will remember from when I put on my Cookie Monster sweater to do a static electricity experiment the other day. I have also added my Cookie Monster eyeballs. This song is for all of you at home who maybe have found your snack of choice, and it is cookies. I am also dedicating this song to Miss Jill, who, though she is not giving us cookies at those lunch dispersals, she is giving us really good food. And Cookie Monster likes really good food, too. But this song is really sort of mainly about Cookie Monster sees you eating cookies, and he would like one, please.
Me got a wish on me mind, it is the chocolate chip kind. Me look at you and me tell you may have snickerdoodle. Me trade me soul for a bite, me spell it out black and white. Me look at you and me see you look like elf in a tree. You cookie showing and me hunger growing. Let's get skillma flowing, let's get this snack going, baby. Me just met you. And this is crazy, but you got cookie, so share it, maybe. Pie and ice cream, it don't faze me, but you got cookie, so share it, maybe.
So think about that. If you ever run into Cookie Monster, he may in fact want one of your cookies.
Okay, in our assembly, we have the GVA staff